The age-old question, do you need maths to become a software engineer? The short answer, no. The long answer, yes. Before we take a deep dive into my answer of the question, I'm going to assume that you can do addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. You should be able to solve basic arithmetic questions like this. If you can't, and you don't suffer from severe dyscalculia, well, you've got bigger problems than wanting to become a software engineer, if I'm completely honest with you. So let's get the obvious out of the way. Some software engineering roles require you to know maths and be able to apply it. Roles like machine learning engineers and game developers. Machine learning engineers are required to study and implement algorithms which will shape the future of the businesses that they're working for. And there are other software engineering roles that work heavily with math, including roles like game developers who work on the physics of a game, on things like gravity and the reflection of a light in a game. And anytime there's physics involved, you know there's going to be a lot of maths. But in other roles, like in the front end or in the back end, there generally isn't a lot of maths involved. So no, generally speaking, you don't need to worry about calculating the inverse of a matrix or converting an integral with Cartesian coordinates with an order of integration of dz, dy, dx, whatever that means. But let's get right into the juicy part, how math doesn't help you with programming. When you're learning how to program, how to code, there's no real knowledge carryover from mathematics, irrespective of how advanced your mathematics is. Everyone that starts has to learn concepts from scratch. Just because someone is quote unquote good at maths, which is a topic in itself that needs to be discussed, that doesn't mean they're able to just code right out of the box. They also need to learn concepts right from the beginning, and they also need to go through the same struggles to learn and understand as well, the same way someone who doesn't have a mathematical background has to also. I know, a lot of you are probably thinking, hold on, programming and coding are just a part of computer science, which in turn is a part of mathematics. Or you're thinking, you know, I've seen someone with a mathematical background try to transition into code and it just seems so easy for them. It's reality and it's the brutal truth that the single most reliable indicator of proficiency in programming is proficiency in math. Oh, whoa, hold on. Before you leave, I know you're probably thinking, I knew it. I have to be good at math to be able to learn how to code. That's far from the truth. It isn't the mathematics that helps people who have studied maths to easily learn how to code, but it's the byproduct of it. This byproduct is common in every single software engineer and it helps them excel in their career. That byproduct is logical reasoning. Maths is one of the best ways to develop logical reasoning skills and algorithmic thinking. It's what sets them apart from nearly everyone else who tries to learn how to code. Maths and coding problems require you to flex the same brain muscles. Think of someone with a mathematics background as a footballer, and think of a coder as a sprinter. Now, a footballer doesn't train to be a sprinter, but I'm happy to bet that they're going to be pretty fast. The same way that the chances of a footballer being very fast is quite high, it's also the same with a mathematician being a good coder. Obviously, there are other non-STEM backgrounds that help you build logical reasoning skills and help you to think algorithmically as well. One of those backgrounds is law. Law students are required to study cases and present their argument in a very logical fashion. Another non-STEM background is philosophy. Students of philosophy are required to build solid arguments that contain no logical fallacies. And there are two things that are common amongst all of them. They have the ability to think logically and have very good problem skills. Those things translate really well when you're trying to learn how to code. However, all of that being said, the only thing that matters is having good problem-solving skills, and it doesn't matter how you've gained those skills. If you have good problem-solving skills, you are good to start learning to code. Now, if you're looking to study computer science at university, then yes, you need to know maths. Most universities require you to have studied maths to be able to be admitted as a computer science undergrad. A place that maths can actually be very helpful outside of learning how to code is when you're looking to do tech coding interviews. The fundamentals of maths and understanding how a lot of these mathematic concepts work will help you significantly when you're doing these tech coding interviews. Some big tech companies, including Manga, require you to do some tech coding interviews. In the more difficult tech coding interviews, you're required to use mathematical concepts to answer a lot of these coding questions. And once you've answered those questions, you're then expected to answer questions on space and time complexity of the functions that you've created, which does require some decent level understanding of mathematics. So the answer to the age-old question on whether you need maths to be able to learn how to code and get a software engineering role, generally speaking, is no. However, it doesn't hurt to brush up on your math skills to get a better understanding of computer science so you have a deeper understanding of what you're writing and what's going on behind the scenes. I hope I was able to answer the question. If you are considering learning how to code but you're worried about your math skills, I can reassure you, some of the best coders that I'd seen firsthand were considered not good at maths. The other things that they brought and the problem-solving skills that they had allowed them to excel and learn code at a very, very quick pace. If all you're wanting to do is get a software engineering role where you're not required to do a lot of maths, I'd say go for it. Don't worry about your math skills. You can start to pick that up as you're learning to code. This is Code with Mohammed, and I hope to see you guys next time, inshallah.